Hello students, in the last class I explained about how to find the maximum bending moment under the given section and also under the given load. Okay, today we will see how to find absolute maximum bending moment. Here what happens in the maximum bending moment calculation, either the load was given or the section was given. But here in this case, absolute maximum bending moment, there will not be any load. Load will not be specified. Even the section also will not be given. So you have to find which load you have to place at the section to get the maximum bending moment, and you only have to find the distance, that load where it lies, that position of that from that load to the left end support. So that both you have to find now, load as well as section. Okay, so that is the difference between the last two problems and this. So we'll see how to find that absolute maximum bending moment occurs under the load which is nearer to the resultant R. Okay, so generally the absolute maximum bending moment occurs under the load which is nearer to the resultant R. Okay, the load system is placed on the span such that the resultant of all the loads and the selected load are equidistant from the center of the span C. Okay, so here what it says means you have to find the load which is nearer to the resultant R. So for that, what you have to do, you have to find the resultant first. Then once if you get the resultant, you can make out which load is nearer to the resultant. Once that is found, then you have to mark the center which is equidistant from the resultant as well as the selected load. That is the meaning of this sentence. Now we'll see one problem, how to solve this. A simple beam of span 20 meter with a set of concentrated load shown in figure. Find the absolute maximum bending moment. Here, four loads are given, 25, 150, 150, 40, separated by these distances. What is the first step? First step, that load also not given and section also not given, where you have to find bending moment. Here, it is asked to find absolute bending moment. So, you have to find, means you have to select the load and you have to find the section also here. Okay, so for that, first we'll find resultant. What is that? X bar is equal to take moment about this point. So that is 25 into 0 plus 150 into this distance 3 plus 150 into 5 plus 40 into this total distance 9. So that divided by the load, all the load, total loads, 25 plus 150 plus 150 plus 40. So you get X bar is equal to 4.27. So round it to 4.3. Okay, so for calculation purpose. So now you have to mark the resultant. Okay, so first draw simply supported beam AB of a span. This span is given, what it is, 20 meter span. So total 20 meter span. Okay, now place this loading system on the beam. So place this 25 kilonewton and then 150 kilonewton and then 150 kilonewton and then 40 kilonewton. Okay, then write this distance 3 meter, 2 meter, here to here 3 meter, this to here 2 meter and 4 meter. Okay, once if it is done, then you mark the resultant. What is that? Resultant lies at a distance of 4.3 from this end. So from this, the resultant lies somewhere here, 4.3. So mark that from here. Okay, from the first load. So from here it is 4.3. How I marked here? Because till here it is 3. Okay, so till here, till this point 150, it is 3 plus 2, 5. So ours is 4.3. So somewhere here I marked. Okay, that is resultant 4.3 from C. Now Till here it is 3 meter distance, 25 to 150 kilonewton load. The distance is 3 meter. So it is 4.3. So what is the remaining distance? That is 1.3. 4.3 minus 3 is equal to 1.3. Okay. Now 150 to 150 kilonewton load, that distance is 2 meter. You know this is 1.3. What is this distance? That is 2 minus 1.3 equal to 0.7. So mark that 0.7. Okay. So now you see which is nearer to the resultant. As per the statement here, you have to select the load which is nearer to the resultant. So which is nearer? See, this load is located at a distance of 1.3 from R. This load is located at a distance of 0.7 from R. So which is nearer to resultant? So this load is nearer to the resultant because it lies at a distance of 0.7 meter, but this lies at a distance of 1.3. So this is small distance. So we have to select this. This is the now selected load. Okay, mark it as selected load. Now 150 kilonewton load is selected. Now you have to find what distance it lies from A. Okay, now this is your X. You mark this load location as X. Okay, so from here to here, what is the distance? You have to see that. And second sentence, what it says, the load system is placed on the span such that resultant of all the loads and the selected load are equidistant from the center of span. So now this is your resultant, this is your selected load. So center is equidistant from resultant as well as the selected load. So mark the center of the span. Okay, total it is 20 meter span. So center means here this is center, this is 10 meter and this side also 10 meter. Mark that. So equidistance means full this is R to 150 kilonewton, that distance is 0.7, but center lies equidistant. So it is 0.7 divided by 2, that is equal to 0.35, and this is also 0.35. Okay, what we want? We want distance from here to here. So distance till here it is 10 meter. So you have to add this distance also. Till here it is 10. We want this extra 0.35. So 10 plus 0.35, it is 10.35. So section is located at a distance of 10.35 from A. That is the meaning. Means you have to write X is located at a distance of 10.35 from A. Now, what is that is A to X. Now, what is X to B? A total it is 20. So, 20 minus 10.35, that is equal to 9.65. That is X to B distance. Okay. This in this way you have to mark the load as well as the section. Once it is done, next you can easily draw what is ILD for bending moment. Okay, so mark this points A, this is B, this is C, D. This we don't want, the center we don't want. Under the load only we want. This is already I mentioned X, so it is E. Okay, now find at different points what is bending moment. So first consider left portion, that is AX, means unit load is in between A and X. So what is bending moment at X? I consider this side because unit load is here, that is RB into 9.65. What is RB? RB is equal to Y divided by L into 9.65. Then at different points, find what is bending moment. At A, Y is equal to 0. So this is equal to, if you substitute in this, you get 0. Next point is at C. This you have to calculate. How you get this? See, till here, till the section, the distance is 10.35. So 10.35 minus 3 minus 2, that is equal to 5.35. Okay, so till here we know 10.35, and this to this also you know 10.35 minus 5, that is equal to 5.35. So at C, Y is equal to 5.35. At C, Y is equal to 5.35. Substitute in this, you get this answer. Next point is at D. What is Y? 5.35 plus 3, it is 8.35. Find. substitute in this. Next, at x, what is at x? Y is equal to 10.35. So find what is bending moment at x. Okay, once it is done, go to the next portion, right portion, x and b, means unit load is now in between x and b. So bending moment at x, unit load is here, so I consider this portion, that is Ra into this distance. What is that? Ra into 10.35. So Ra is L minus Y divided by L into 10.35. Then find at different points. First point is at X, Y is equal to 10.35. Substitute in this, you get this. Next point is at E. So Y is equal to 10.35 plus 4. So it is 14.35. So substitute in this, you get this answer. Next point is at B. So full distance, Y is equal to 20. So you get this. Once if you get these points, mark those points on the diagram. So at A it is first 0, next it is at C 2.58, at C 2.58, at D 4.03, at X it is 4.99, then right portion at X 4.99, then at E it is 2.92, then B it is 0. Okay, at the section you have to get the same value whether you calculate from right side or left side. Next, for how to find bending moment, multiply this load with this corresponding ordinate. So absolute maximum bending moment is equal to 25 into 2.58 plus 150 into 4.03 plus 150 into 4.99 plus 40 into 2.92. so you get absolute maximum bending moment is equal to 1534.3 kilonewton meter. Okay, so these steps are same for all the cases, whatever, whether the bending moment at the given section or whether the bending moment under the load or absolute bending moment, this procedure is same. Only the selection of load and the section that is different, that's it. Okay, so here absolute maximum bending moment asked, so there is the load also will not be given and section also will not be given. So you have to calculate both the load as well as section. How you can find the load, that is which load that is close to or nearer to the resultant, that load you have to select. Once that is selected, you have to locate what distance it lies from the left end support. So for that, mark the center point which is equidistant from the resultant as well as the selected load. Once it is drawn, then you can draw the diagram. Okay, this is the way to find absolute maximum bending moment for the series of loads. Thank you.